Hello everyone. So today I present you a person who truly defines being a woman. So here we have Mrs. Gagni Gill. Hello ma'am.
Thank you
so much for your precious time.
Thank you for having me. It's a pleasure.
So would you please tell us something about yourself?
Well, my name is Gagni Gill. I was born and raised in Africa, but I belong to a Punjabi family, a Sikh family. And I moved to Canada in 1998 for further studies, got married there in 2001, and since then I have been there. But during this whole episode of my life, I would say that it's been a very interesting journey because I grew up in Ethiopia. I came to India to study in 1995, like ages ago, and I ended up being Miss Punjab, which opened up a very new chapter of my life, and that was joining the Punjabi industry. And I was introduced into the Punjabi industry by the great legend, Mr. Dara Singh Ji. I was the only face that he actually has introduced. And I ended up doing 4 Punjabi films during those times. That gave me quite a name, but Punjabi industry was not that big of an industry in those times. And my name took me towards film anthology. It took me, and I decided I wanted to call it quits and go further on with my studies because I was very young. I was like 15, 16 years of age. So I was sent to Canada for my further studies, and there I continued being an RJ, radio RJ. I went into modeling, and life just continued, and then I got married.
So, you started your career from being Miss Punjab.
That's right.
In those years.
Those years.
So, you are very multitasking. You did modeling, and then you're a brand ambassador also for
that's
many.
That's right. In 2012, I also got another title, which is Mrs. United Nations, worldwide. So I was the second runner-up. This pageant was held in Jamaica, and it is, we all know what United Nations is.
Yeah.
So that was another privilege that I call it a privilege because it's a very big title to win. And so that even took me very deeply into philanthropist activities. I was very, very close to my father. He's one man I love the most just in my life. I lost him at a very young age because of cancer. So that death somewhere put me into the work of cancer, I would say. I started helping people, or I wanted to help people suffering from cancer and or any other way or any other form. And I ended up getting the privilege of being the North American brand ambassador for Imran Khan Cancer Hospital, which is Shaukat Khan Hospital in Lahore, Pakistan. And then we have a very big association here in India, which is called Roko Cancer. This Roko Cancer is actually run solely by the donations of NRIs. Yeah. So right now it's grown very big, and it was started by a wonderful gentleman, Mr. Chawla from the UK, and he started this because he lost his wife from breast cancer. So Roko Cancer is another privilege that was given to me to be the brand ambassador for Canada for Roko Cancer.
So through all your journey, what has inspired you the most?
The feeling of being a mother both the time that I held my son is a feeling that I still can't express in words. It's been years now. But when I remember those moments, they make me alive. They make me want to live more, And the second thing is the drive to keep growing,
So what's the message you would like to give to other girls of my age and myself, of course?
That's such a wonderful question. The biggest pride I have held is being this little girl of my father. At this present time, I am this wonderful, elegant woman, but I still am the daughter of my father, that little daughter he has raised. And I think that's the biggest privilege you are given when you are given, when you're born as a woman. That's the biggest privilege God has given you. And please appreciate it, be proud of it, and listen to your soul. Don't listen to anybody else. Listen to the voice of your soul and walk that journey, because your soul will guide you very right. It will take you where you belong.
Thank you so much, Mom, for your precious
time. Thank you, and I wish you all the best for your future.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thanks.